What do you think motivates the people who come to work with you daily? Are they really, really happy with the kind of work they are doing? Do they take pride in what they do? Or do they consider the work to be a burden and just work for the sake of earning money? All these assumptions about the team members help the team leaders decide what kind of management style they need to opt for. Based on the kind of approach which people have in life, what motivates them actually help determine the kind of management style that needs to be followed. That is what one of the theorists, Meg Grigor, talked about in his very theory of motivation. Today, I'm going to cover Theory X, Theory Y on motivation given by Mr. Meg Grigor. According to him, there are two types of people. Ones who have a more pessimistic approach, who don't like to work, they consider work to be a burden and just work for the sake of earning money. Second category people are those who really love what they do. They consider work to be like play. Just like playing is for child, work is for such people. They are really very happy with what they are doing and they give their 100% to complete any task which is assigned to them. So he classified the theory of motivation into two, theory X and theory Y. According to him, theory X is applicable to all those people who don't like to work at all. So what would be the thing that will motivate them? Only monetary rewards and social security is something that is going to motivate such people. You need to instruct them every now and then to work. They'll not work willingly. You have to command them, instruct them, reward them only if they do good. Otherwise, you have to punish them. This is what going to motivate them to work. So if we compare it with the Maslow's need hierarchy theory, then the lower level needs, like the basic physiological needs of food, clothing, shelter, or the basic safety needs, the safety from any kind of a physical, emotional harm, social security, that is something which is going to motivate these people on whom theory X is applicable. So what kind of people will be covered under this theory? The ones who do usually the low-skilled or the unskilled jobs. Talking about theory Y, it's applicable to all those people who love to work. They are really very satisfied with the kind of work they are doing. They are happy doing what they do. So you don't need to instruct them every now and then, command them, reward or punish them to work. They will be working willingly if you are fulfilling their basic motivational needs. So they know what is to be done, when is it to be done, how is it to be done. You don't need to instruct them every now and then. If you are giving them the respect, if they are getting the recognition, if you are making them participate in the decision making, if you are empowering them, if you are giving them really very creative, good tasks to undertake, they will be motivated to work and they'll continue to work the way they are doing. So this theory Y, which talks about the management style where you need to let the people work, delegate them the authority as they know what is to be done, is usually applicable for the highest skilled jobs. Okay, so this is how Meg Grigor talked about two contrasting personalities and the two different management styles which you need to opt for the people covered under both these theories. So under theory X, you need to be more of an authoritarian kind of a leader. You need to instruct them, command them to follow all your orders. But if I talk about theory Y, you can opt for a democratic leadership style or you can go for a free reign leadership style where you will let the people under you take the decisions for themselves, give them the authority to work. So this was all about the Meg Grigor's theory X and theory Y on motivation, which talks about the lower level needs which motivate people on whom theory X is applicable and the higher level needs which motivate people on whom theory Y is applicable.